Friends, today we meet to think through Remembrance Sunday as we remember those who have died as a result of many, many wars in the past and wars that continue today. We remember their sacrifice. We remember that we are where we are because of people who went to war quite often, not because they wanted to. So let us think about where we are coming from so that we learn the lessons of the past and make sure we do not repeat the same mistakes. And we continue to look through the centrality of Jesus in our faith. The Lord be with you. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. In times of peace, in times of conflict, we remember that we are not alone. As we gather to remember, let us sing and pray. Let us worship God together.
In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row, that mark a place, and in the sky the lark still bravely singing flies.
Scarce heard amid the guns below, the dead short days ago. We lived, felt tall, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie
in Flanders fields.
In Flanders fields. Quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch, be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not keep the poppies grow
in Flanders fields.
Lord, you promise a place in paradise to all who call to you in penitence and faith. Lord, have mercy. Lord, you bring comfort to those who mourn and have suffered loss. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you speak your word of peace in times of conflict and calm our fears. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And so let us confess our sins, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in peace and love with our neighbor. Together we pray, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon our sins and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and keep us in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray the collect together. Gracious Lord, your Son came to bring the good news and power to transform our lives. Grant that when he comes again as judge, we may be ready to meet him with joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory.
Sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished.
I will boast in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom, but I will boast in Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 13, reading from verse 1 to 8.
Glory Christ, our Savior.
As Jesus came out of the temple, one of his disciples said to him, "Teacher, look, what large stones and what large buildings. Then Jesus asked him, do you see these great buildings? Not one stone will be left here upon another. All will be thrown down. When you are sitting on the Mount of Olives opposite the temple, Peter, James, John, and Andrew asked him privately, tell us, when will this be? And what will be the sign that all these things are about to be accomplished? Then Jesus began to say to them, beware that no one leads you astray. Many will come in my name and say, I am he. And they will lead many astray. When you hear of wars and rumors of wars, do not be alarmed. This must take place, but the end is still to come. For nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be earthquakes in various places. There will be famines. This is but the beginning of the birth pangs. This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. Listening to today's gospel almost feels like a story of the end times. There was a time, especially when I just received Jesus as Lord and Savior at university, I was convinced that Jesus would be back before I completed university. I didn't know why I was actually studying, because it was unlikely that I would complete my studies. The rapture was on the way. Because there comes a time when people preach to you and you listen to this and you are convinced it's about to happen. But as one grew in faith, I even became aware that people like the Apostle Paul, many years ago, also thought the end was imminent. And so we then tend to focus on the end and not the message. We are in Remembrance Sunday, and we remember people who died in World War I, World War II. I'm sure during World War I, some people thought this is the end, and there was no end. World War II, this is the end. And even maybe for some, 9/11, the end is here. So we focus on the drama and not the message. And what you have today is the disciples of Jesus looking at the drama of the beauty of the buildings in Jerusalem, the drama of the building, the temple, how awesome it looked. And it certainly did, because materials had been brought from all parts of the known world to build this magnificent building to the honor of God. And so looking at it, it appears as if the focus became the building and not who the building represented. So as these disciples are marveling, Jesus says, do you see all this? Well, one day all this will be no more. And there's silence. Because for the disciples, how you dare destroy this enormous, beautiful building. Our faith is grounded in these buildings, in the things we see, in the drama. And I'm sure as they were growing up, there'd been stories they were told about how the building had been built and how Solomon had done this and that. And suddenly to be told, it will all be gone. So you have these other disciples saying, Jesus, we need to understand. I wish I was there to see the demeanor of their asking. Tell us, what's going on? As I'm sure we are anxious for those of us who have heard stories of the rapture and the end times. Tell us, how is it going to happen? When is the trumpet going to sound? Why the drama? Jesus says, hold on. You are still going to hear more. There are people who are going to come and claim all sorts of things. I am Jesus. I'm the Messiah. I'm the healer. I'm a prophet. I'm all that. There will be wars. There will be threats of the end. Well, in my time, there was a time we were told that when the year 2000 comes, it's the end. Y2K. Do you remember? We are here 21 years later from Y2K, when the computers should have crashed. You know what? The computers became better than Y2K. But Jesus seems to be saying, friends, that actually, focus on me. The drama will unfold. Stories will be heard. People will do whatever. Just continue focusing on me as the Christ sent from God. Do not be afraid of the stories out there because you have not heard enough. It doesn't matter. They will be there. There will be wars and rumors of wars. We are in a war right now. We are in a pandemic. This is a war that's fighting all of us, not us against each other. But yet, even in this war, where we wonder what's next, is the fourth wave coming? Or if after the fourth wave, is there another virus coming? These are the stories. It unsettled us. It changes our view, just like being told that the building you love is going to be destroyed. We look at this and say, the world as we know it has changed. The people as we know them have changed. Our habits have changed. But Christ remains the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. So even in these times of fear and rumors and people claiming all sorts of things, promising all sorts of healing and drama, Jesus says, all that as you know it will change. But I'm here. So we should not be afraid of the rumors and the stories. We should not be afraid of buildings falling down. We should not be afraid of our lives changing. Because there's one thing that remains sure, the foundation, and that's Jesus Christ. So even as we journey towards Advent, I think if you continue reading into the Sundays, you'll see that the readings will become more and more dramatic. You even hear readings about the moon will turn red and the moon will fall. But Jesus insists on reminding us that all these things will happen. Like the waves of an ocean crashing. And yet, our faith is grounded in Jesus. And I think that's the reminder we need to continue with friends. And those of you who are especially of this parish, you've been here longer than I have been, and I mean here on earth. You know much more than I do. What is your constant? Your constant should be Jesus the Christ, with all you have heard. And I'm even sure for others they panicked. Yo, now we have a new priest. And how many seasons of new priests have you gone through? But Jesus remains the same. Remember that. Do not be afraid of all these things. Jesus the Christ is here for you and I. Amen.
Sure.
as we remember the families of those who continue to die in the many wars in the world, we pray for the leaders of the nations that in making decisions, they may not put our lives at risk. May God grant them wisdom. We remain mindful of the pandemic we find ourselves in, COVID-19. We pray that God may continue to inspire doctors, scientists, and all healthcare workers as they seek to find a cure. But we also pray that God may still our hearts, that we may believe and trust in God's guidance. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you have taught us to pray and to give thanks for all people. Receive our prayers for the Universal Church, that it may know the power of your Spirit, and that all your children may agree in the truth of your Holy Word and live in unity and godly love. We pray for your servant, Nkosinathi, our bishop, together with Thabo, our metropolitan, and for all other ministers of your word and sacraments, that by their life and teaching, your glory may be revealed and all nations drawn to you. Guide and prosper, we pray, those who strive for the spread of your gospel, and enlighten with your Spirit all places of work, learning, and healing. We pray for those who have authority and responsibility among the nations, that ruling with wisdom and justice, they may promote peace and well-being in the world. To this congregation and to all your people in their different callings, give your heavenly grace that we may hear your holy word with reverent and obedient hearts and serve you truly all the days of our life. In your compassion, Father, comfort and heal those who are in trouble, sorrow, need, or sickness. We praise and thank you for all your saints, for the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and for the heroes of the faith in every generation. And we remember before you your servants who have died, praying that we may enter with them into the fullness of your unending joy. Grant this, Holy Father, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is your living Word through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who placed their hope in you, and so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of the evil one and banish the darkness of sin and death. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now, with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious God, accept our praise through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on the night he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." And so we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Remembering therefore his death and resurrection, we bring before you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. As Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Lord God, in this Eucharist we have shared, you have spoken your word of life and nourished us with your mysteries of Christ's body and blood. Bring us with all who have died in combat or through the injuries of war to know the joys of heaven. We ask this through Jesus Christ, who lived and died and was raised to newness of life, to whom be glory in every age and for eternity. Amen. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. In Jesus Christ our Lord, send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among us and remain with us always. Amen. And so, let us continue in love to serve the Lord. Amen.